On Saturday, 4th of July, Kanye West tweeted out something that may have broken Donald Trump's heart. And that something was Kanye's announcement that he is going to run for president this year. Here's the tweet. He said, "We must now realize the promise of America by trusting God, unifying our vision and building our future. I am running for president of the United States. Hashtag 2020 vision." Kanye and Donald Trump, that's been an unlikely alliance. Out of all the weird things that have happened during this administration, that was probably one of the least predictable things. Kanye's visited the White House. He's actually done a little bit of good. You know, he and Kim Kardashian on the issue of prison reform. So that's good. But Kanye has also kind of gone off the deep end a little bit. He said when he wears his MAGA hat, he feels like he's a superhero, which is a little weird. And now, though, in spite of the fact that he has been good buddies with Donald Trump, he has been an ardent supporter of Donald Trump. He says he is running against him this year. Well, here's the thing, folks. He actually has already passed the deadline to run as an independent in most states in this country. So that can't even happen. He would have to actually find a real political party to run as their candidate. That ain't gonna happen either. He does have time to do that, technically. But according to the FEC, he has made no filings. He has no staff. He has no platform. He has nothing. There's absolutely nothing set up that would suggest that Kanye West is legitimately running for president of the United States. What is actually on the horizon, though, is that he has an album coming out. And so this is likely just a promotional tool, a way to get a lot of attention. And then suddenly, once everybody's looking at him, he's like, "Hey, here's my new album. Ha ha, I'm not running for president because whatever." But here's what it says to me. It says that the office of the president has been cheapened so much over the last few years, not just by Donald Trump, really, but cheapened overall, you know, since Nixon. You know, cheapened further by Bill Clinton, cheapened even further by George W. Bush, and then cheapened to hell and back by Donald Trump. Cheapened to the point where it has now become a joke. It has become a publicity tool. That is what Kanye West is using it as. You know, when Donald Trump welcomed people like Kid Rock into the Oval Office, you know, that was kind of the end of the legitimacy of that office. Yeah, horrible things have happened in that room in the past. True. You know, but this has really turned it into a spectacle. You know, making it not just a place where you go and have your affair or you go and you plan your illegal wars, but a place where you can come and get a photo op and feel powerful for a minute. That is what Trump has done. He's cheapened it to where it's, you know, you stand in line, you get your picture taken. Maybe it costs you a couple dollars to get in there. Who knows? But that's what it is. And that's what Kanye West wants to use it for. It's a publicity stunt. He's not actually running for president against his good buddy, Donald Trump. And even if he did, he's not going to get enough of the vote to even register across this country. People look at Kanye West today a lot like they look at Donald Trump. At some point, you were probably relevant, but a lot of people don't even know what it is that made you famous in the first place at this point. All you are is a self-hyping egomaniac who has no business whatsoever trying to run the United States.